It is our first weekly update of the baseball season. Head coach Rob Bishop is with us. And coach, we joked before we started this that with the negative temperatures, double digit negatives in Brookings this week, Ernie Banks's let's play two certainly is hammering home. But what's it feel like here to finally have baseball back as far as games are concerned?
Well, the guys are obviously excited and the coaching staff's excited. We haven't played since, you know, second week of March last year. And even most of our guys didn't get the opportunity to even play summer ball with COVID-19 and everything that comes with that. We had a great fall as far as weather, and we were actually pretty uninterrupted. So had a good preparation season, you know, kind of a spring football season for baseball. And so we're ready to go. And you know, at this point, we've practiced enough. We just need to see what competition looks like and find out what we need to work on.
How has your crew handled all of this, the adjustments and the uniqueness of it? Like you said, they're used to playing all the time. They didn't get to play most of them last summer.
Yeah, you know, I would say the average position player in our program plays 100 games a year. And, you know, the pitchers are probably throwing 75 to 100 innings a year. And, you know, I don't know if a position player played more than 20. And pitchers obviously haven't thrown much, so we up the inning load in the fall, and we've really tried to mitigate what we can from a physical standpoint. I still think the biggest challenge of this whole thing for a student athlete is just the overall social implication and the togetherness and the on-campus environment and just basically kind of getting to be around people. Most of our guys are really social animals, and the team is what they're about. So that's been the biggest challenge, not the baseball piece.
Do you get a sense, though, that having baseball every day, being able to come to practice, be together, not only gives them a little bit of that togetherness, but also it's sort of an escape from everything else going on, isn't it?
Absolutely. It's been our only piece of normal. I mean, for 2.5 hours a day, guys get to come in and kind of feel like this is just a normal year. You know, the guys aren't any different around each other or around the coaching staff during that window. They're actually probably happier and more engaged than usual because I think they recognize, like all of us do, the things that you take for granted in life. And, you know, hopefully this gives everyone some perspective on the things that are really important to us, and, you know, being around the people we care about.
Let's talk a little about the specifics of this team you'll put on the field beginning this weekend. What would you consider the strengths of your program right now?
Well, I think, you know, we aren't a what I would consider a veteran team as far as a lot of juniors and seniors, but we're a really athletic team. We have a lot of guys that have some utility. They can play all over the diamond. You know, we have a really strong third-year group that are technically sophomores. So, you know, they're only sophomores, but they have a lot of experience. A lot of those guys have played a lot in their career. Drew Beasley, Luke Ira, Ryan McDonald, Derek Hackman. Obviously, we have, Landon Badger, Tyler Olmstead, Brett Mogan that are the seniors that have a lot of experience. So we're gonna lean on those, you know, 8 or 10, 12 guys that have a lot of game experience. We have plenty of talent around the diamond, just not a lot of game experience. So I'm really excited to get this team out on the field.
How do you handle the pitching staff? Because normally you want to kind of ease them in a little bit, but you also, because you haven't played in so long for a lot of these guys, does that change the approach for the opening weekend?
Well, it really changed our approach to the fall. I would say that we threw more in the fall and deeper into the fall than usual. As far as our normal January, February routine, we're almost just right on schedule. So our starters are, you know, they're up to 75 pitches-ish. And, you know, so on a normal year, you'd hope to get 4 or 5 out of your starters on opening weekend. And that's about where we are. So, from that perspective, I don't think we've changed a lot.
Couldn't help but crack up when you said normal year, because nothing's normal this time of year. You intended to open up the season at Kansas. That was the plan. Things have been moved around a couple of different times, trying to find a way to make this happen. And baseball is always adapted, college baseball. It's find a way to play games somehow, some way. And that's what you and the Jayhawks have done for this weekend.
Yeah, I mean, initially we had moved the series to Dallas from from Lawrence, and then, you know, Dallas is having South Dakota weather this week, so now we're going to meet in US Bank Stadium. So Grunsky and I joke all the time about the first 4 weeks of the season. Sometimes we get on the bus and we don't know where we're going or who we're playing, but we usually figure it out. And that's just the life of any baseball program in the North, I think, this time of year. And so we're adaptable, and this year, the reason we're adaptable this year is different, obviously, but I think that's a strength of baseball programs across the Midwest.